Hello everyone, I welcome you all. It's so nice to see all of us healthy and safe at our home and during this lockdown period. And it's Dr. Nidhi Singh, on behalf of CIET NCERT, I welcome you all for this live interactive session that we are going to have continuously every day almost. And we will be continuing it till the demand is there. I mean, we are in the lockdown and people say that yes, we still need it and we want live sessions and all. So we will be continuing it. It's a regular process and we will be doing it almost every day except Saturday, Sunday. I just hope if Bhaira sir is kind enough to spare us on Saturdays and Sundays during this this lockdown period. और इस लाइव सेशन में आज का सेशन जो है वो मिस संगीता गुलाटी मैम जो है वो लेने वाली हैं गूगल एप्स पे डिफरेंट टूल्स वो बताएंगी जो हम यूज कर सकते हैं अपनी टीचिंग लर्निंग के लिए. वो हेड है मैथमेटिक्स डिपार्टमेंट की संस्कृति स्कूल न्यू दिल्ली में और एक नेशनल आईसीटी अवार्डी भी है. 2016 में इनको अवार्ड मिला था एंड ये गूगल सर्टिफाइड इनोवेटर और ट्रेनर भी है साथ में.
Thank you, Nidhi, and thank you, Dr. Bhaira, for giving me this opportunity. I'm grateful to you to open this platform for us to share our learnings. And today's session is just the first of many other webinars that are going to come up. And today, I'm only going to talk about the very basic tools, basic understanding of what we mean by G Suite of Education, and also talk about a little more about Google Drive. So this is going to be a continued process. It is not going to be a deep dive into the Google apps in first go. So we will take our time and we will explore a few other things, special tools, special ways of using Google apps, perhaps in our next lesson. So just to get started with, it would be wonderful if everybody can be on the mute. It will help us to hear you. And if you want to switch off your videos so that that is not causing any distraction, that would also be helpful. So when we think about Google apps, Google Suite for Education, there is a slight difference in the way we look at it. But if you already have a Gmail ID, then you already have lots of tools in your Gmail. So we will be looking at some of those coming up today. So we will be looking at making certain use of those Google apps which are already sitting in your Drive. So to begin with, I'm looking at the G Suite for Education, what it means, what does it entail to say G Suite for Education. When you're looking at a whole possibilities, number of apps here, they all are making a lot of difference in the way we are looking at how education can be done, where we are bringing in technology in terms of children not only being a consumer but also a creator. So looking at this here, we are looking at number of apps. These are their icons. Some of them you would be already familiar with. So we are looking at Docs, Sheets, Slides, Drive, and Jamboard. So these are all apps which can help you collaborate anywhere, anytime. The other two icons, Calendar, you are all very familiar with. But we are also looking at Google Keep. So Google Keep is, again, a wonderful, powerful app which would help you maybe starting with even making your to-do list for your home or what you're going to buy in, at a maybe vegetable market, to curating content. So if you want to put content together or web links together in one place, which you can then share with your students, then also Google Keep is a great tool for that. The other two things that are making a big difference in today's classrooms all across the world and here in India as well is Google Classroom and of course the Google Forms. So Google Forms you may be familiar with, which you might have used to submit a certain survey, but it works wonderfully to be a tool, which an app, Google app, which you can even use to convert forms into self-assessed quizzes. So again, in a remote learning environment, Google Forms is playing a crucial role as of now. So Google Classroom is something which you may not have experienced, but Google Classroom is the learning management system, a portal under which everything comes together for a teacher to interact and create these learning opportunities. So you can have an interaction with student. You can also create assignments. So we will be in our due course of more sessions, we will be looking at how Google Classroom can be made use of and how powerful it is. Of course, you're familiar with Google Mail, so you know the Gmail. You're also familiar with Google Hangout. But what you also have with G Suite for Education is Google Meet, which would allow you to create these live sessions. Like right now, we are using an app called Zoom for video conferencing. But Google Hangout Meet session is something which is restricted to the domain. So if I have a school which has a G Suite for Education, then only my students can join in. And of course, to control all of this together, if you are going for G Suite for Education, then you also get a chance to manage these apps at one point. So the Chrome admin person can take care of all the administration as to which apps students should be allowed to use, whether you want to control something, and also see how children and how much of a consumption is being interaction is being done with these apps. So this is a bigger picture of G Suite for Education. We are going to go across and try to cover some of them a little more in detail and then come back in another session with more deeper details and also show you some live examples of how these apps can become not only just a word processor or a presentation tool, but also help you to let children bring up certain creativity, can show their creativity, and also let the children create and not remain a consumer. And to begin with, but it's very important for one to get familiar with the bigger component of it as to where do I start? How do I know and where do I go if I want to use Google Apps? So to begin with, we are looking at using the Drive. So if you already have a Gmail account, you are familiar with Google Drive. So we will be looking at using Google Drive in terms of various ways, trying to understand what it does and then take it forward from there. So what is Google Drive? It is nothing but a place where you can create and organize files. But it is a virtual cabinet. It is not something which fixes you or puts you in one place and you cannot move away from that kind of a solid actual cabinet. But you can access this from anywhere and everywhere and anytime. So you can have the Google Drive access from your phone or from a PC or from a laptop or wherever you may go, the drive will go with you. We are also looking at the idea of this coming in from, you know, the storage that we are doing. So the storage of the data that we otherwise do somewhere restricts you to a hardware, but here everything is being stored in cloud. So we are not using or looking at putting the files in the pen drive or in the CDs, which were definitely old ways, but everything is stored virtually in a cloud, which you can access from anytime, anywhere. With G Suite for Education, Google Drive comes with unlimited storage. So even if you are creating videos, you are creating digital content, it can be stored there without a worry about how much space it is occupying. So definitely this is a way to go forward and to have the confidence that you would not be able to lose any material, lose your file, lose your data. Again, when we use technology, and right now, since I am not very familiar with Zoom, so I'm not going to stop the annotation aspect of it. I know as a host, I can do it, but I would like to request the participants not to annotate the slides right now. When you get a chance to be a presenter, then please feel free to do this annotation. So if Nidhi or somebody else can also help me to make sure that participants don't do that. So it would be really helpful if you do not do this activity right now. So when you're looking at that, well, I have an eraser and I know that, you know, I can erase these things, but I don't want to stop in between. So please help me focus on the presentation. We are all here with a certain purpose. So you can try and experiment with Zoom later on, right? Okay, so moving ahead, what we are looking at is what else do we find in the drive and what do we do with the drive? So we will be coming back to, because today's session will be more on drive, but we are also looking at the various apps. So we have Google Docs, which is nothing but a word processor. So you are using it to put text. At the same time, the beauty is that this Google Doc would allow you to create or share this document with a number of people. So you will not end up with multiple versions of the same document. So you create a file and then you send it to your co-teacher and she downloads it and then work on it, but then there are multiple copies coming in. So Google Doc would let you share the same file with the multiple number of people and everybody can work together on the same document virtually, and you can actually see also that collaboration happening in the live real time. So that is definitely a big advantage of having a simple Google Doc. Of course, you can add comments, so you can review, and we will be talking about these settings later on as to what makes and this Google Doc such a powerful tool. So you're looking at maybe sharing with the person where he or she has only the rights to view it. But you might want to share it with your co-teacher who might want to add more content to it. So you can have different editing rights. We will be taking a look at that and see how you can open it for anyone. So you can see if I open a Google Doc with anyone to work on, then we know that the information would be lost. It might be destroyed in the way that some people might remove all the content from there or might overwrite on it. But I can choose to whom do I want to select with. So I can select with specific people and I can also put certain restriction on the settings of sharing. So this is definitely something that we will be talking about. With students, how this work, I'm going to give you a brief idea as we go along, is if I create a Google Doc and I've shared it with the students, as they are working, we will be able to comment on the lesson as it progresses and you can kind of encourage and help them to move ahead. At the same time, as an intra-department work, you can create a lesson plan and all the teachers teaching that particular level can also contribute to that. So there are mainly that we are looking at four documents that would definitely be coming in use again and again. And that would be your Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, and Google Forms. These are the four apps that would play a great role in the way you use Google Apps. So just a few examples for you, which I'm putting up here. So if I'm looking for Google Docs, it can be used for individual or collaborative writing. You can have summaries created by the students. You can have certain reflections or certain documentation of inter and intra department work. You can even start just a question bank. And that question bank can be shared with the students with only view rights. And you can keep updating it as you go along. So that is one of the ways that you can look at making use of the Google Docs. Google Draw is one of the apps that I did not highlight earlier, but it is one of the most versatile, most powerful app for Google, which is available in your drive, which would let you and your students create. So it is just a blank page. In fact, all Google apps are blank. You have to create, you have to bring up those learning opportunities for your students. And there you can have multiple media inserted. You can have a a YouTube video linked up, you can have an image inserted. You can give students certain images like here, and students are asked to recreate the life cycle of a butterfly or even a concept map. Google Slides, when we think about, they are more often thought about as presentation tools. So I'm using right now Google Slides. So Google Slides are definitely presentation tools, but if you use them in context of how your children are learning and what kind of task you want to create for your students, then you can have just a small word organizer kind of slide created for them, where the child, so this is based on the Freire model, where we are looking at the word would be put here. So you can allocate a word to the children. Each child gets one word, and then they talk about and share the definition perhaps, or the historical connection to the unit, or maybe gives an example or a non-example. But more than that, what you allow them to do is get more digital content in it. So they can find a picture which represents that word, which explains that particular word. So there is so much that you can build on a slide. And it is going to be a collaborative deck. So every child will have one slide, one word. But if there are 30 students in the class, at a glance, in a particular maybe period, you would end up with a creation of 30 such descriptions, and therefore vocabulary development definitely will happen. Every child can see somebody else, everybody else's work, and that would bring a lot of value to it. Even for the younger ones, when we think about our smaller children in junior classes, one wonders how we should use technology, or should we or should we not is another question. But even a drag and drop activities can be created, because we do expect children to learn to hear a story and then put it in sequencing. And if you give children a chance to do that through digital media, that also adds a lot of value to it. So we are looking at multiple uses of Google Slides. So how we create these activities, I hope I'll get a chance again to come and share that learning with you. So we will talk about how we create such activities in future episodes. And of course, the deck, as I was talking about, if it is shared by all, then as a teacher, you at a moment can get a look at all of them together, and students can get to see each other's work. It brings a whole lot of value in a classroom. Google Forms, when we think about, then Google Forms is just a survey tool, yes, but as at any time when you're looking at a teacher, you always want to do some formative assessment. You want to check whether the children are learning or not. So this is proving to be one of the most useful app of Google for teachers across the world, because we are now realizing the value of that self-assessment, the quizzes that you can create, and also not only just quizzes which are giving you a data to see how many children have done it right and wrong, but you are also getting a chance to send some feedback to the students immediately. So Google Forms turned into quizzes, again, one of the most useful way of using Google Forms is done with the idea of adding certain value to it with certain feedback, where an image or a text or a video link and a web link can be added so that the children get to learn and improve on their learning. At the same time, what you see here is a view from Google Classroom. And then I, as a teacher, get to see who all have done it and not done it, and how well they have done it just by a few clicks. So Google Form definitely is something we will spend more time on in our future webinars. Coming to Google Classroom, something which you may not have experienced so far. So what Google Classroom does is it gives both you as a teacher and as a student certain important, very useful opportunities. What educator can do is they can create classes. So it's a 24/7 virtual classroom where you are interacting. So at any given time, whether it is in a situation where we were seeing children every day in our classroom, and now when I'm not able to see the children, not able to meet the children, I have a platform where the children can reach out to me. So there is a classroom where the students have joined. I can connect with them. I can give them the assignments. I can grade their assignments, send the feedback, and all of the resources that I'm sharing right now will remain in one place till I archive that class and the session gets over. So even if we are doing work in the month of March and April, the students will have access to it till the end of the year, all in one place. They don't have to click on multiple links or go cross searching for where was that particular file. And for a student, again, as I said, the same opportunities, they would be able to join classroom, they can reach out to the teacher and to the class, and it would be also a possibility to send a private comment, which would mean that if a child is very shy, doesn't want to talk about it openly in the classroom, they can reach out to the teacher through Google Classroom. And believe it, they do. When they want to just let you know that there is a problem, there is a struggle that they're facing with a certain concept, or they're lagging behind, they reach out, right? They do attempt assignments, they access resources, get feedback, and have all of this in one place, classroom, which they can access at any given time. So this is totally what we are looking at as G Suite for Education, bringing you all of this under one umbrella. And I will be sharing some resources at the end for you to access and read more about these. But today we thought we'll also take a kind of a slow approach and start, as we titled it, getting started with Google Apps. Just even if you are familiar with Google Drive, we will take a little bit of a deep dive into understanding what Google Drive looks like, what it does, what kind of opportunities you have there of creating, and how, what kind of content are there available. So let's go into a Google Drive and see that in live action, even if, as I said, you are or you may be already familiar with it. So, okay, so when we are looking at Drive, what does a Drive look like and where does one go looking for the Drive? So again, very important is to get familiar with certain, parts of your inbox and otherwise. So this is what we call as the app grid of Google. So this you can find even when you open your Gmail. On the top, there are these 9 dots, and these can be used for you to access all these apps. So that is one way you can access Google Drive. At the same time, you can always go directly and type in drive.google.com, and you would be able to see your Google Drive if you are signed in with your Gmail account. So that is, multiple ways of getting into the Google Drive. So this is the Google Drive as of now, and there are usually loads of files in my Google Drive. This is an account only for the training purpose. So you would not see that clutter, but it does get cluttered if you do not organize your work. So let's get familiar with few of the possibilities here. When you look at this Google Drive, you have, as a regular Gmail, you have only 15 GB of the storage. So when you click on this new button, there are these various options that are coming up of creating a folder, a file, or a folder upload. So you can upload a folder from your personal computer, and it would be possible to move files from your device into the Google Drive. And then you can create various documents, docs, sheets, slides. And then hidden under the more interesting ones. So you have Google Forms, Google Drawings, Google My Maps. We will be bringing up this as well in the later sessions. Google Sites is a definitely must try thing for you. And of course, Google Jamboard. I'm not familiar with Google App Script, but yes, it is more powerful when you want to do a little bit of coding to make your work more efficient. So yes, go ahead and try these various options there. So again, the very first thing when you start working with Google Apps is to make sure that you have a certain organization. So always start with Google folder. In the Drive, always start with a folder. So click on folder, and a folder as an untitled folder will not be a good way to organize. So give it a certain name. So if I'm going to call that as demo one and I create this, then I know that all my content of that class, say 11th class, is going to be in this folder. And anytime I want to retrieve something, I'll open up this. So let's double click this and open. And right now it's absolutely empty. So in this Google Drive, we are going to create more files. And here you can find various ways of creating. So let's start creating a blank document, which is a Google Doc. So when you create a Google Doc, it is again blank. There is nothing in it, but you have few toolbars openly up on the top. Again, very first thing that we must always do is to name the document. Otherwise, your drive will be full of untitled document and you would not know which one is what. So you're looking at these possibilities, which are now a blank page open, and you can start creating anything. You can also, in fact, have a header and footer put in. So I can call it demo 01, right? So I can have that done, and it will be definitely possible for me to do that, what you are already familiar with. This should not be anything new for anyone. But getting a header basically means that it will run through all the pages. Now, this is something which is very similar to any word processor. So I don't think there's a much of a mystery in it. So I would like you to perhaps search and play with it on your own. But what is interesting is that within this Google Doc, you can do some research. So if you look at this bottom right corner on my screen, there is something like a plus sign, which if I click, it says explore. So if I click on explore, then it opens up the web research right there itself. So I can find some documents that can be, or some particular research for a particular topic. So suppose I want to get a certain image inserted here, then I can search the docs that I have created, and also I can search the web for certain images. So suppose I want to search for an image and I want to search for, say, Taj Mahal image, then all the related information for Taj Mahal opens up here. I can click on images and I can see various images of Taj Mahal coming up here. Suppose I like this one and I want to insert it in between. All I have to do is click on this little plus sign and the image will come up in the doc. So it is not a copy pasting from an external source, but here in the Google environment itself. I can, of course, resize it just like you would do for any other situation. You don't want it to take the whole page, so you can always resize it. And also, if you click on it, you would be able to see the source from where it has been picked. So you're looking at all of that information coming in the Google Doc itself. So there is much more power to Google Doc than it appears in this case. And as we go forward in our sessions, we will be looking at how we can perhaps create a doc like this and send it out to our class, where each student would get their own copy and they will be able to do certain assignments where we are giving them some directions of do this, research for that, get certain points collected, put your research together. And all of that is in the safe environment of the Google Drive and Google Apps. So this is something which is much more powerful than anything else. Going back to the drive, what does it look like? So if I close it, again, there is no save button. If I just close it, it's getting saved automatically in the drive. So again, I created, if I just refresh this here, then we should be able to see that document created and being present and filed in the way that we would like to. So you're looking at this demo one was the name we gave to the folder, and inside the folder is that file sitting. If you do not choose the folder, then it will be a file somewhere in the drive, and you may have to then search for it, which is not very difficult. You can actually go to search drive and you can just type in demo and then maybe some words coming up with that, and you can see, you can get a demo folder, you can get a demo file, you can search within the Google Drive as well. That is definitely more useful as you start making use of this more and more. But what else is here? Let's explore this. So you have My Drive, which is the environment you are able to see right now. And you are looking at the second one, which is Shared With Me. So when somebody shares a file with you or a folder with you, then it is residing under Shared With Me. It is not showing in your drive. So here we are not able to see the folder, but somebody, if they share that folder with me, then I'm able to see that folder in the under the Shared With Me. I can always add this to my drive, or I can further share it with somebody else. So we'll come to the sharing settings in a minute. But also important and useful is the recent. So if you have done something recently and you want to see what are the things that I have created recently. So all of these files I had recently opened in my drive, and you can immediately see them. Again, when you select a particular file, either if you open it or if you right click on it, you get to see these various options. So you can even share a file without opening it by just clicking on this share button. And now if I start, say I want to share it with somebody, and if I want to share with my account, so if I want to just say, okay, let's share it with her. And so this is another account of mine. And if I say, okay, I'm going to share this, then I can choose the settings. So this is right now by default edit. If you don't want the other person to edit but to view, then you can choose just the view. If you want person to view but you want some feedback from them, then you can choose the setting of can comment. So that is something which you have to be careful with. And of course, put a note there. Also notify the person. If this is clicked, then you will get a notification in the inbox as well. So the person with whom you are sharing this document will get a mail saying that so-and-so person has shared this mail, this document, and these are the rights with it. So that is something very easy to do, but it is useful in today's world when we want to collaborate with people. You can do the same thing with a folder. So if I click this folder of demo one, and I can see this little icon of the person with a plus sign, then that is what we are looking at as the share button. So Nidhi ma'am, would you please let me know if there are any questions?
Hello, good afternoon ma'am.
Good afternoon.
How to share our say Google Drive documents. So ma'am, are you going to do it for just Google Drive, or you are going to explain some other apps as well?
In today's session, it is Google Apps. So all Google Apps will be explored as we go along. But the sharing is almost similar. I have just now demonstrated for Google Drive and Google Docs. So the sharing process is the same.
Thank you so much for organizing it, ma'am. So making the lockdown very fruitful by this way. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for a wonderful session. This is Neeti Mahendra from Bangalore. Can I ask my question?
Sure, sir.
First of all, thank you so much. It was really wonderful interacting over this presentation and listening to it. My question is there any limit to the number of participants in a Google Classroom?
No, there is no such limitation. I think there is almost like a tops is 250, if I'm not too wrong. But I don't see any limitation right now on that.
Okay, and my last question is, can we conduct an online examination using Google Classroom?
Google Classroom is not meant for an online examination. Yes, you can always assign a Google Form quiz, perhaps. So that can be a self-assessed quiz. You can use that. There, if you are working in a Google Suite for Education domain, and if your children are working on managed devices, that is Chromebooks, which are in sync with the Google domain that your students are working in, you can lock the screens. So you can not let the children open any tab. So that kind of a system can be done.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am. This is Shritama Gupta from Kolkata. May I ask my question?
Yes, Shritama.
Ma'am, I joined in a little late. So I just want to know how to start with using this Google Suite for Education. So is it an app or do I automatically have it on my Google? How do I start with it?
Right. So there are two ways or two things that we are looking at. One is using your Gmail account. That is not Google Suite for Education, right? So you are looking at, but you can use Drive, Docs, etc. through the account that you already have. But to use Google Classroom with the students, you need to register your school domain with Google. It is free. You don't have to pay for that. So I'm putting up this resource on my slide. And I have certain documents in the folder which I'm sharing with you, which would give you more information on how to get started with it. So if you want to register, then what are the ways where, so it's all online registration. So you will be able to then access the information and then follow up from there.
Okay, and about using the Google.
Sorry, before we go to the next question, just to add to it, this is just an overview of all the things today, but we will be having a separate sessions on individual things in the coming days.
Right. Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
One more request, ma'am. Whenever you are organizing the such kind of thing, if you could let us know a day prior at least so that we can join in time, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. We will be giving the complete list of schedule in our webinar page, and that will be shared shortly with all of you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Dr. Angel. This is Dr. Behra. Actually, it is a question for we organizers from NCERT, and as Dr. Angel rightly mentioned, we are making a day-wise schedule. Even we will be going in-depth on each tools. So maybe you will be listening to Dr. Sangeeta couple of more times with couple of more tools also. So the detailed schedule will be available on our site. We will also share on social media. At least for 1 month, we will be doing that. So it will be the same time, 3:30 to 4:30.
Actually, sir, we are the students of Exxon Research, and it has come on our group. So likewise, if you could put it always so that we can join in, sir. Thank you so much.
Sure, definitely. Dr. Angel will do that.
Sir, we are very happy that you took this initiative of helping us learning and once again using the lockdown very fruitfully.
Thank you, Tejas. I think we are talking to Tejas.
Hello, Poonam Garg from UP.
Hello, Poonamji. Hi, Poonamji.
Hi. Okay. Now I want to ask that how can we share a screen in Google Classroom or in this app?
Ma'am, you can't share screen in Google Classroom. There, if you have G Suite for Education domain, then you can use Google Meet. Then we can share screen and do the presentation as a video conferencing, but not through the Google Classroom.
How can we download G Suite Google app? It is free or have any cost?
G Suite for Education is free, but your school, your institution will have to register the domain. So I have put some resources under this link. It's a shared folder. You can copy the link and check it out later and see if you can follow up the online procedure there.
Personally, download the G Suite for Education without any...
No, ma'am, you can't. It has to be through the educational institution.
Sangeeta ma'am, can I ask a question about the same thing?
Yes, sir.
I am Gurpreet from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Jafarpur, Delhi. Actually, I was trying to register my school under G Suite, and it just showed that it is a free trial for 1 month, or I got a confusion. Or after that, it is written that it will take 250 rupees per user. Now, I just want to ask, means per user means only for the teachers or even the students are considered as user?
There is some fee for managing the Chrome side of it in terms of various settings, various apps that are going to be available and all. So that is one time payment that has to be done.
Hello, ma'am.
Okay. Ma'am, will this class continue every day from today?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
3:30 to 4:30 every day we will have class. So maybe a different tool on a different day. So today,
thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Maybe tomorrow she will be there, or next couple of days she will be coming back with some more tools. So
thank
we'll
you.
Have
thank
every
you, sir.
Day one more tool, one new tool.
Good evening, ma'am. This is Alpa here.
Hi, Alpa.
It was nice listening to you after so long.
Hi, Alpa. Yes.
Ma'am, there is a question. Can we add audios and videos to Google Slides?
Yes.
Or hyperlinks?
Hyperlinks as well, you can always, but you need to actually have, if it is your own audio, then you need to get that audio file in your Google Drive. So the audio gets linked only with an MP4 or any other file from your drive. So you save the recording in your file and then link it up.
Thank you.
So आज हमने Google Drive में related जो भी चीजें हैं वो सीखा मैम से संगीता मैम से Google Sheet, Google Docs, Google Art, Google Form, Google Classroom etc. जो भी किसी के question से if you have any question further question you can put write in the chat we can later on do it और आपसे सब लोगों के साथ schedule share कर लिया जाएगा most probably today Angel मैम she's the coordinator she'll be sharing all the schedule for few for almost a month or so different tools होंगे उसमें so I would again like to thank everyone thank you thanks a lot Sangeeta ma'am